Streaming services are great, but watching a film in a movie theater is an experience in itself that most of us enjoy once in a while. The big screen, the comfortable seats, and the great sound system. But sometimes the screen is too close to the seat is broken, and the sound turns into noise as the speakers are simply too loud. And this is because the theater is probably not following the rules. Yes, every state government has the authority to regulate cinema theaters, including the setting of ticket prices, seating conditions, noise levels, and safety measures. In this video, we'll look at the specific cases of Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, and Maharashtra. But if you live in some other state, you can look up the rules for your state on lawsofindia.org. We begin with Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, which have, for the moment, the same rules regarding movie theatres and multiplexes. These are governed by the Andhra Pradesh Cinemas Regulation Act, the Andhra Pradesh Cinemas Regulation Rules, and subsequent amendments made to these. There should be a 0.9-meter wide passage for every 10 rows of seating. The minimum width for gangways is 0.9 meters. No seat should be more than 10 seats from a gangway. The distance between the screen and the first row of seats should not be less than the height of the screen. In multiplexes, the first two rows of seats from the screen should be priced lower than the rest of the seats. Air-conditioned theaters should fix Fahrenheit thermometers at 3 to 4 visible places inside the theater. Temperature should be maintained at 76 to 80 degrees Fahrenheit throughout operating hours. As for toilets, it is mandatory for theatres to have one urinal for every 50 persons for the exclusive use of each gender. Also, fresh and clean free drinking water in adequate quantity should be available. Parking fee cannot be levied on those who produce movie tickets or invoices of purchases made in the mall. The maximum permissible noise levels inside a cinema theater are 90 decibels at source, 86 decibels at 5 meters, and 80 decibels at 15 meters from the source. Slides or video provided by the government may be played before every show for 5 minutes if non-commercial. Now you know that it is because of this rule that the legendary Rahul Dravid appears in low resolution, warning you against tobacco before every movie. There should be no regular shows before 8:40 a.m. or after 1:30 a.m. The operative conditions provided in the Legal Metrology Act and the Legal Metrology Packaged Commodity Rules need to be met. Also, the provisions in the Food Safety and Standards Act should be made for all food sales in theatres. What this means is that packaged food cannot be sold above MRP in theatres. In multiplexes, the exit and entry points of the theatre should have the same standard of lifts and escalators. A short documentary showing the exits, emergency escape routes, and steps to be taken during hazards should be played before every show. And emergency helplines of the nearest hospitals, police station, and fire department should be displayed before every show. Complaints should be filed with the district collector in districts and the police in cities where there is a police commissionerate. And while we are used to thinking that there's no point complaining because this is just the way things are and they're never going to change, we urge you to think again. In 2018, a resident of Hyderabad realized that a multiplex he frequents doesn't provide free drinking water and lodged a complaint through WhatsApp. The police responded and the multiplex now serves free water, all because of a few WhatsApp messages. Again, in Hyderabad, the management of a multiplex was asked to pay a fine for selling bottled water for more than the maximum retail price following a citizen complaint. All this means that if we have avenues to complain against disregard for rules, we as citizens must put them to good use. Let us now look at the rules for cinema theatres in Maharashtra. There should be no more than 20 seats per 9 square meters without passages in between. Except for private boxes, all seats need to be firmly secured to the floor. There should be chairs with folding seats wherever required. Benches should have arms fixed so that each seat is separate. There should be intervals of at least 30 cm between the back of one seat and the front of the seat immediately behind it. The distance between the screen and the front row of seats should not be less than the width of the screen. Seats should be arranged like an arc with the concave edge facing the screen. The minimum width of the cinema screen is 3.05 meters. The percentage of parking space at the theatre should be according to the population of the town or city where it is located. The space for each motor vehicle should be 5.5 into 2.5 meter. In cities and towns except Greater Mumbai, the open space near a cinema should be 12.2 meter on the front side of the cinema towards the road and 6.1 meter on the remaining three sides of the cinema. For safety, every theatre should have tanks filled with water, hydrants, fire buckets filled with dry sand, chemical extinguishers with directions for usage displayed prominently, fire extinguishers, buckets with water, a bucket of sand within the enclosure, and one fire extinguisher immediately outside the enclosure. People in Maharashtra are allowed to bring their own food to movie theatres, but right now the Supreme Court has put a stay on this. Across the country, the GST on movie tickets is 12% on tickets up to 100 rupees and 18% on tickets exceeding 100 rupees. Just like watching a movie on the big screen, eating out at a restaurant is an occasional treat we allow ourselves to enjoy. Food establishments need to follow a set of rules too. So let us turn our gaze to the rules to be followed by restaurants and food business operators in India. Unlike movie theatres, food establishments across the country follow the same rules. The rules given in the Food Safety Act should be followed at all stages of handling food. Operators or people acting on their behalf must not manufacture, store, sell or distribute food which is unsafe, is misbranded or substandard, contains foreign particles, needs a license except in accordance with the conditions of the license, is for the time being prohibited by the food authority or central government or state government, or is in contravention of any other provision or rule of the Act. Operators should not employ people suffering from infectious or contagious diseases. They should not sell any article of food to any vendor without a written guarantee about the nature and quality of the food. In the absence of such a guarantee, the invoice or cash memo will be considered as guarantee. Service charge is voluntary, not mandatory. It is not a government tax, but a kind of compulsory tip charged by restaurants. If a restaurant collects a service charge, they should mention it in the menu. GST is payable on service charge. Consumers have the right to ask for and check a restaurant's license. Carrying out a food business without a license can lead to imprisonment for up to 6 months and a fine of up to 5 lakh rupees. Selling, storing, distributing or importing food containing foreign matter will lead to penalty up to 1 lakh rupees. Restaurants can charge more than the MRP for bottled water. GST cannot be charged on products being sold at MRP. If GST is charged on MRP products, complaints can be filed with the Assistant Controllers of Legal Metrology, which is a part of state governments. Complaints against food quality in restaurants may be filed with the local municipality or the Food Safety Standards Authority of India online. We believe that awareness is the first step towards change, because when you know your rights, you will know when they are not being upheld and you can then take steps for redressal. If you found this information useful, please like and share this video and leave us a comment with your feedback. Thank you for watching.
Subscribe to Factly and hit the bell icon for updates.